As we count down to the new year, just 16 days until 2022 arrives. In Times Square, the NYPD is fine-tuning its security plans. The department's mounted unit will have officers riding high above the crowds. Eyewitness News reporter Lauren Glassberg has a look.
In a city of subways, taxis, and pedestrians, you can still find some horses. This is the NYPD mounted unit out on the streets. They're often in Times Square. Today, they are riding with Santa, who's drawing a fair bit of attention, but mostly it's the horses that draw the crowds.
I could just stand here and I'll just have like a whole bunch of people come up to me and ask me all sorts of questions. I've had people like cry to me, and I'm just standing there and listening. It's almost like therapy in a way.
Officer Edwin Aguilar was raised in the Bronx and had never been on a horse before he applied for a post with the mounted unit. He rides Thor, and the two even made the Police Foundation's annual calendar that raises money for the NYPD canine and equine units.
In the beginning, I would say it's like very surreal. You're like, wow, I'm on a horse. And then like after a while, you become so comfortable with it. It's like almost nothing just walking through. It's like a routine day walking through Times Square with your horse.
Inspector Barry Gelbman and Fantin have been a team for almost 14 years.
Everybody loves to see the police horses, and we're very visible. So when we're out, if there's anything going on, we could direct pedestrians.
The horses have been ridden throughout the pandemic. They have never taken a break. Even last New Year's Eve, when Times Square was a frozen zone, the mounted unit was here.
We were sitting on 7th Avenue and 44th Street in the middle of Times Square by ourselves. And you never see that again. It's a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
But this year, the ball drop will be a spectacle. The horses on site helping officers see above the crowds and helping those in need see an officer who is 10 feet high. In Times Square, Lauren Glassberg, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.